Have you ever wondered how hackers can steal passwords and sensitive information right out of thin air? Today we're going to uncover the secrets behind one of the most powerful techniques in a hacker's toolkit. But first, let me ask you this. Do you feel confident that your online activities are truly private and secure? Welcome back, ethical hackers. In our last video, we delved into the world of ARP spoofing, learning how to position ourselves in the middle of network traffic between a target and their router. Today, we're taking our exploration a step further. We'll uncover how an attacker could leverage this position to inspect network traffic and potentially capture sensitive information. Before we dive in, I need to emphasize a critical point. The techniques we're about to discuss are powerful and potentially dangerous. They should only be used in controlled, authorized environments, such as your own network or in a professional setting with explicit permission. An unauthorized use of these methods is not only unethical but also illegal. Our goal here is to understand these techniques to better defend against them, not to cause harm. Let's set the stage for our ethical hacking scenario. Imagine you're a cybersecurity professional tasked with testing your company's network security. You've successfully performed an ARP spoofing attack on a test machine, and now all its traffic is flowing through your device. What's the next move in your security assessment? The tool we'll be using today is called Wireshark. It's a powerful open-source packet analyzer used by network administrators and security professionals worldwide. Let's walk through the process step by step. First, open Wireshark on your Kali Linux machine. You can do this by typing Wireshark in the terminal or finding it in the applications menu. When Wireshark opens, you'll see a list of network interfaces. Select the interface you used for the ARP spoofing attack. In our case, it's WLAN 0. Now click the blue shark fin icon at the top left to start capturing packets. You'll immediately see a stream of packets flowing through your machine. It's like watching the Matrix. But all this data can be overwhelming, so let's focus our analysis. To make things easier, we'll set up a filter to look at HTTP traffic, which is often unencrypted. In the filter bar at the top, type HTTP and press enter. With our filter in place, now we wait. In a real attack scenario, the attacker would patiently monitor the traffic, waiting for the target to visit websites or enter sensitive information. For our demonstration purposes, let's say our test machine visits an insecure website and attempts to log in. For this example, we'll use a purposely vulnerable website called Aquart, which is designed for testing web application security. On our target machine, we'll navigate to VulnWeb. This is a deliberately insecure website used for testing purposes. Remember, never enter real credentials on sites like this. As we watch our Wireshark capture, we'll see the HTTP requests start to appear. Now, let's simulate a user logging in. On the target machine, we'll enter the following credentials: username, techsky, and password, subscribe. In Wireshark, we'd see a post request to the login page. Right-click on this packet and select Follow HTTP Stream. A new window will open, revealing the contents of the HTTP request. In plain text, you might see something like this. Just like that, we've captured a username and password. In a real-world scenario, this could be absolutely devastating. But this is precisely why we always stress the importance of using HTTPS. This demonstration underscores several crucial points. First, it shows the immense power and danger of combining ARP spoofing with traffic analysis. Second, it highlights the critical importance of encryption in protecting sensitive data. And third, it illustrates why you should never, ever enter sensitive information on websites without HTTPS. As ethical hackers and cybersecurity professionals, understanding these techniques helps us in several ways. We can better identify vulnerabilities in networks we're tasked with protecting. We can demonstrate the real-world risks of unsecured networks to decision-makers who might not fully grasp the technical details. And perhaps most importantly, we can develop and implement more effective defenses against these types of attacks. So how can we protect against this kind of attack? There are several key strategies. First and foremost, use HTTPS everywhere. As a user, always check for the padlock icon in your browser before entering any sensitive information. As a website owner, implement HTTPS across your entire site. It's not just for login pages anymore. another powerful tool in our defense arsenal is the use of VPNs. A good VPN encrypts all your traffic, making it unreadable even if intercepted. It's like putting your data in an unbreakable safe before sending it across the internet. Whenever possible, use secure protocols. Prefer SSH over Telnet, SFTP over FTP, and so on. These encrypted alternatives to older, insecure protocols can make a world of difference in protecting sensitive data. Network segmentation is another crucial strategy. By dividing your network into smaller subnetworks, you can limit the scope of potential attacks. If an attacker does manage to gain access to one segment, they won't automatically have access to everything. Regular monitoring of your network for unusual ARP activity is also essential. Many modern network monitoring tools can alert you to potential ARP spoofing attacks, allowing you to respond quickly and mitigate the threat. For critical devices, you might even consider using static ARP entries. This approach can be challenging to maintain in large networks, but for a small number of crucial systems, it can provide an added layer of protection against ARP spoofing attacks. Remember, the goal of learning these techniques is not to exploit them, but to understand the mindset and methods of potential attackers. This understanding is crucial for developing robust defenses and for educating others about the importance of cybersecurity. It's like learning the tactics of a chess grandmaster, not so you can cheat, but so you can better defend against those tactics. In our next video, we'll explore some advanced techniques for detecting and preventing ARP spoofing attacks. We'll look at tools and strategies that network defenders can use to identify and mitigate these threats in real time. Until then, stay curious, stay ethical, and happy hacking.